on the x-axis, I am taking the time. On the y-axis, I am taking the voltage. It is the zero. It is a zero. See, this one is a positive potential and this one is a negative potential. It is a plus V and this one is a minus V. This is for, this is called input. Positive half cycle, negative half cycle. Positive half cycle, negative half cycle. Two directions I have, that's why it is a AC current. I am applying AC current here. Then you get here, what sir? Output as a DC current. How AC is converting into DC? See here, it is the diode. I am taking a point here. Say point name is a point. You concentrate on a point. What happens? This A point is positive. This A point behaves like a positive for positive half cycle. A is positive for positive half cycle. Positive half cycle. And this A point behaves negative for negative half cycle. Negative half cycle. What is A point is positive for positive half cycle. A point is negative for negative half cycle. If that behaves in such way, what happens? See, here I am sending positive half cycle towards the diode. For example, this part is going. This part is going towards that. It's a positive half cycle or a negative half cycle? It is a positive half cycle. For positive half cycle, how A point behaves? For positive half cycle, A point behaves like a positive. See, it is a P part of the diode. It is a N part of the diode. P part is connected to positive. P part is connected to positive. Forward bias or reverse bias? Forward bias. What is forward bias? P side is connected to positive half cycle. Okay, both are positive. Forward bias. In forward bias, current is more or less? In forward bias, current is more. In forward bias, current is more. I'm extending this one. This one is a input. Now I'm drawing for output. What happens? Output. Okay. Here I'm drawing output also here. Output. See, it is a zero, right? This positive half cycle can passes through the diode. Why that positive half cycle is passes? Because per positive half cycle, the diode is in forward bias. For positive half cycle, the diode in forward bias. That's why that allows the current. This pattern can enter through the diode. Now I get same pattern. This one as it is. As it is, I am getting here. As it is. Positive half cycle completed. Now go for negative half cycle. This negative half cycle reaches the diode. What happens? For negative half cycle, the A point behaves like a negative. So P is connected to negative terminal of the battery. Which bias? Reverse bias. For positive half cycle, forward bias. For negative half cycle, that acts as a reverse bias. In reverse bias, current not passes. That's why this part is not passes through the diode. This as it is, empty space. For positive half cycle, the diode in forward bias, that passes through the diode. For negative half cycle, the diode in reverse bias, that's why current is not passes. Now come again for positive half cycle. For positive half cycle, how this diode behaves? For positive half cycle, the diode behaves as a in forward bias. In forward bias, current is what? In forward bias, current is passes. So current is passes in forward bias. Again come here, negative half cycle. For negative half cycle, diode in reverse bias. Again, this part is not passes. This part is empty. See, it's a one direction or two direction. We are getting only one direction. One direction means this is what, sir? This output is a DC. This input is a AC. So what is doing this device? This device converting, this entire device converting AC current into a DC current. Why I am getting gap here? In that gap, the diode behaves as a reverse biased. That's why current is not passes. I am getting a gap in between. This is a half wave rectifier. What are the points you should remember? In half wave rectifier, I am using only a single diode. In half wave rectifier, I am using only a single diode. That diode behaves as a forward biased for positive half cycle. That diode behaves as a reverse biased for negative half cycle. It's a positive bias, forward bias. It is a reverse bias. In forward bias, current is passes. In reverse bias, current not passes. That's why current passing, not passing. Passing, not passing. Passing, not passing. We get unidirectional current. This current is called as a direct current. This device is converting AC current into DC. That's why that is a rectifier. Then what is the efficiency? What is the efficiency of that half wave rectifier? We have to know. What is the efficiency, sir? Simple. Efficiency formula. Efficiency symbol is eta. Efficiency formula, output by input. Output power by input power. This is the efficiency formula. What is the efficiency? You should directly remember this formula for half wave rectifier. Efficiency is equals to 0.406 into RL by RF plus RL. This is the formula for efficiency of half wave rectifier. What is 0.406? No need to explain. That is a equation. 0.406 into RL. What is RL? RL is a load resistance. How much resistance you applied? We have to take calculations. What is the RF? RF. RF is what, sir? RF is a forward resistance. RF is forward resistance. Again, RL is a load resistance. So in a question, he gives a forward resistance and load resistance and he calculates the efficiency. What is the efficiency formula? 0.406 into RL by RF plus RL. And how much percentage that is converting? See here, what is that? 0.406. How much percentage that is converting means just 40.6. 0.406, I am telling in percentage. Only 40.6% of AC current is converted into DC. Only 40.6, that is a less percentage. Remaining nearly 60%, it is unable to convert. It can't converting nearly 60%. That's why we have another rectifier. That rectifier name is a full wave rectifier. In full wave rectifier, we have more efficiency. More percentage we can convert AC into DC. That is a full wave rectifier.